When Todoist launched their foundations project late last year, there was a lot of new features. One of those features is the task view, the new task view. Now, within that task view, you can create subtasks. Now, initially, when you checked off a subtask, it would disappear, and you'd have to go into the menu and to find the phrase that said show completed tasks. Well, Todoist has made a few alterations to that, and now the default setting is those tasks will show, even if you've completed them. And that brought me to realize that actually now what you can do is you can create checklists inside Todoist. Now, I know that Thomas Frank and Matt Develia have done a couple of videos in the last few weeks on checklists, and checklists are a really powerful way of making sure you're doing the right things at the right time and in the right order. Now, if you combine the new subtasks and the duplication feature that Todoist has always had, you can build your very own checklist templates within Todoist, and that is what I'm going to show you this week. So before we go any further, I would just like to say, if you like this video, please help me by clicking on that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you want to get the latest news, tips and tricks on Todoist, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, it's now time for me to take you in to my very own Todoist demo account, and I will show you how to set this up. Okay, now I want to show you a quick trick before we start, which is something that I noticed the other day. Now, this is my demo account, so I don't use it every single day. Now, this is from last week's episode when I covered my time boxing and my time blocking session. But what you'll notice is, because I'm not using this every day, what I've got here is I've got a large number of tasks that are overdue. Now, in the past, what I've done is just done a shift click and gone all the way down to the bottom here and shift click again, and then I've pressed schedule and I've chosen today. That usually brings everything up, and it does bring everything up. That's one way of doing it, but I did discover there is a quicker way of doing it. If you just see up here, you've got reschedule. Now, you'll have this come up whenever you've got tasks that are overdue. Now, for me, when I've got overdue tasks, which do occasionally happen, particularly on a weekend, I just send them over for today, and then I can reassess when I go through my list for today. All you need to do is use this section here to reschedule. So just hit that. I'm going to move to today, and now everything is moved into today's task, which is really, really quick way of just rescheduling everything. I just thought I would give that one as a quick update for you. Now, the purpose of this is checklist. So I've got one in here, and I don't know why, for some reason, it's telling me I've got seven when I've actually only got one. Actually, I do have seven, and there's a reason why I have seven, I've just realized, is because I've created a checklist. Now, this, I'm on a trip right now, I'm in Ireland, and what I've got is a checklist right here. And the way I've done that is I've created that as subtasks using the information, the task view section here. So I've got six subtasks right here. Now, this is fantastic because one of the things that you can do is you can create templates from this, because you can duplicate the task. Now, if I just come out of that, I can just go into here and I can duplicate this task. So I can duplicate the task, and now it duplicates. And if I go in here, I've got all my tasks that I had before. So that's a really, really one. So now, one of the problems that I've always had with templates in Todoist is that you have to save the template either as a CSV file, or you save it online, and then you got to go looking for it, and then you got to import it. Well, actually, all you would need to do if you had a lot of templates is create a new project, call this templates, and you can keep it at the bottom of your projects list. So I could add that there. And now I have a templates folder here, and I can then take this and I can just say drag for my, I could change the name of this one because this is a duplicate. Let's change the name of this. So just going to go into here, and I'm going to call this travel checklist and save it. And then what I'm going to do is I'll go into my in here, and what I'm going to do is these things here are always going to be on my list. These things are unique to my current list. Now, what's going to happen is you'll see that they disappear, which is not what you want. But after a few seconds, they reappear down here. So now I actually have
the checklist so they will see what I've actually done. This is really one of the core things. What I'm going to have to do here though is I'm going to delete this task. You have to actually delete the task. So delete that task. Actually, I'm going to undo that because you have to, before you check it off, you actually have to delete the task. I should have done that first. I'm going to delete the task now and delete that one and delete the Yorkshire tea because this is just additional shopping list that I want. So I'm going to delete that. So now I have my basic checklist. Now, of course, there'll be other things that you want to add to that, but this could be then my travel checklist. And all I have to do then is drag that to my templates. And now I have a template folder that I can just pull up anytime I want, go into that travel checklist, go to here, click duplicate, and then move it into my this week or next week's project folder. So that's cool. Let's go back to the original one here. So Ireland trip here, I'm going to go back into my task list here. Now, one of the things I want to do is, this is my shopping list, if you like, and these are my regular items that I need for the checklist. What I'm going to do is I'm going to add a subtask. I'm going to do asterisk, which gives it a non-completable task and items to remember. Now, for me, I personally prefer to bold these as topic headers. So I'm going to give that the exclamation marks just to either side of that, like that. That now bolds it, and it didn't bold it. because I did the syntax completely wrong. Let's just go into here. I didn't do it. Oh, right. Okay, so that option has now disappeared on subtask. So it still doesn't matter because what I really want to do is let's go back into that. What I want to do is I want to drag that one up. Whoops. I want to drag this one up here. So I'm going to put that one up at the top. Items to remember. And then I've got my list here. I'm going to create another one, which is shopping list, which I always have when I come to Ireland because there's a lot of things that I like, for example, my Yorkshire tea that I can't buy in Korea. Oops, I've done that wrong. I'm going to put that the asterisk there, do that. And now I've got my shopping list there, and I'm going to add, going to the task review because I know that we've got a tiny little problem. It's going to come in here. There we go. And I'm going to go into the best place to do this, by the way, is actually inside the task view. So I'm going to hide that minute. I'm going to add a subtask. I'm going to put my Yorkshire tea, which probably would always be on my checklist because it's something I always have to buy when I come, and Guinness tumbler for my wife, and that's done. So now I've got my checklist. So this is a checklist that I can use. And so I'm going to add the date. It's already added for today, and I'm going to add it to the project of this week. And it's no section, and I've got it flagged already as a P1 because I'm already on the trip. So now when I go into my today's view, because it'll be there, I'm going to do this. This is done. Let's get rid of those two. So my Ireland checklist is here. My travel checklist is here. Actually, it shouldn't be there. I need to remove the date on that one. So let's just remove the date. No date. Done. That's okay. So what I've got here is now I can just open that up and say, right, I've done that, I've done that, I've done that. All these things are done. That's great. I haven't bought the Yorkshire tea yet, and I haven't bought the tumbler. And so that is done. As you can see here, they've disappeared from my today view. That should be in my shopping list, which is here. So I'm going to go into my information here. And the shopping list, everything is there, but I've got all the things that I've done is now down here, so I can check that. And the things that, so it's nice and tidily organized for me, so I can actually see what things I have to remember. This needs dragging. Actually, I can just check that one off because it's been done. So these things are now in here. Yorkshire tea is done twice. I'm going to get rid of that because I didn't delete them properly. My mistake. So there we go. So those are the things that I've got in there. Items to remember is done. If I'm finished with that, I can just go into here and I can just delete that off. And remember, this is now just remaining my shopping list, the things that I have to buy before I come back. Now, for those of you also who are doing the time boxes, and sometimes you may have something that actually is a project that has a number of tasks that you want to keep track of, then you could create it in a mini task, like a sub mini project. And there's another use for this feature, but it's something that I think Todoist didn't initially launch with their new foundations project, but it's something they've added in the last few months. And I think it's just for those people who really want to see everything that they've done, then this is a great way to do it. So there you go. You can create checklists in Todoist. They're really simple now with the with this particular task view, and you can create your own templates to keep them together. So there you go. Hopefully you found this really useful. Thank you very much for watching this episode. Don't forget to stick around at the end of this video, because I have a very special offer for you with my Productivity Masterclass course. Thank you very much, and it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Thank you very much for watching this video. Now I have a question for you. Are you ready to go beyond the to-do list? Now, the reason I ask that question is because your to-do list is never going to do the work for you. Your to-do list is only ever going to show you what needs to be done. And that often can cause a lot of anxiety, a lot of stress, and a lot of overwhelm. What really helps you to get your work done, and what really helps you to become much more productive, is developing your own workflow. A workflow that you work from every single day that makes sure that you stay focused on the things that you have identified are the most important things to you. Now that could be your work, it could be your goals, it could be your family, it could be your personal life, it could be your self-development. Whatever that is entirely personal to you. But the key is to develop the workflow so that you are consistently making small steps towards achieving the things that you want to achieve every single day. And that's why I have developed my Productivity Mastermind course, Creating Your Very Own Custom Workflow. And I would love for you to check out the course. The course is available now, details of which are in the notes below, and I would just love to see you in this course. So please join me in the Productivity Mastermind course, Developing Your Very Own Custom Workflow, because this is a course that's going to take you way beyond the to-do list so that you start to really move forward on the goals and the things that you have identified are important to you. Thank you very much.